Were you one of the lawmakers who walked out of the parliament before voting began?
Yes, it's highly unfortunate. We were hoping that by stepping out, we could delay the voting process for a few minutes so that we could wait for Mr. Lau Wong Fat, who has been sick for a few days, to come back and vote. Unfortunately, a few of us did not step out of the chamber in unison, so there was sufficient quorum for the vote to go through. So we lost the chance to vote in support of the government motion.
Now, one of your rivals in the pro-democracy camp has accused you guys of so-called dirty tricks to try to stop the voting. How do you respond to that?
I think that's totally unjustified. In the past, pandemic legislators have stepped out of the chamber when they wanted to delay the voting process. These rules are well understood. We all wanted to vote for the motion, even though we knew we were unable to provide a two-thirds majority. It was totally unpremeditated and is certainly not a dirty trick. All of us highly regretted losing the opportunity to vote.
How do you feel at the moment?
The veto was to be expected. We all expected the motion to be vetoed. But the inability to vote is really deeply regretted.
What's next for Hong Kong in terms of future reforms?
I think the democratic progress of Hong Kong is now stopped in the rut because the government is not going to resume consultation or negotiation. The conditions for consensus is not there because our pandemic colleagues are unwilling to accept the basic law nominating system as the basis for building a consensus.